click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see one more problem which is based on area between the curves. Let us start with problem number 6. Find the areas between the parabolas y square minus 2x is equal to 0 and y square plus 4x minus 12 is equal to 0. Now let us try to convert this parabola in a standard form first. So this will give you y square is equal to 2x. Thus you can see the power of x is minimum. So this will go in the positive x-axis direction. In the second part you can see we have y square is equal to minus 4x plus 12. Taking minus 4 common, we have x minus 3. So this parabola is a shifted parabola. Also at the same time, you can see the power of x is minimum and the sine of x is negative. So this will go in the negative x-axis direction. But the center of that parabola will lie at 3, 0. Just equate this bracket to 0. If I say x minus 3 is 0, it means the value of x will be 3. So the parabola will start from the point 3, 0, while this parabola will start from the origin. Also, let us find the point of intersection of these two parabolas. To find point of intersection, we need to solve these two equations simultaneously. The value of y square, that is 2x, can be substituted here. This will give you 2x is equal to minus 4 into x minus 3. We have 2x is equal to minus 4x plus 12. Taking this minus 4x on the left hand side, we have 4x plus 2x is 6x is equal to 12. Therefore, the value of x will be 2. Now, let us substitute the value of x as 2 in the first equation. This will give you y square is equal to 2 into 2, that is 4. So, y will be plus or minus 2. It means there are two points of intersection. When x is 2, y will be plus 2. And when x is 2, y will be minus 2. So we have two points of intersection, that is 2, 2 and 2, -2. Let us draw these two parabolas. So the first parabola, y square is equal to 2x, will go in the positive x-axis direction. While the second parabola, having its origin at 3, 0, will go in the negative x-axis direction. So the coordinates here will be 3, 0. This is the parabola y square is equal to 2x, and this is the second parabola y square is equal to minus 4 of x minus 3. Also, we have found out the two points of intersection. One is 2, 2, while other is 2, -2. Now, this is an area which is lying between the two curves. So, to find this area, we can first find this region and then multiply it by 2, as the above and the below area will be symmetric. Now to find the above area, we can split the given parabola from this point. As you can see, this area is contributed by the curve y square is equal to 2x, as this area lies between that parabola, while the remaining area is contributed by the second parabola, as that area lies between the second parabola. Now we will add these two areas and get the value of this entire region. After that, we can multiply it by 2 in order to get the final answer. Therefore, area will be area under parabola y square is equal to 2x from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2. This parabola is only contributing from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2. Plus area under y square is equal to minus of 4 into x minus 3 from the second parabola is starting from 2 to 3. X is equal to 2 to x is equal to 3. And that entire region is supposed to be multiplied by 2. because by this formula we are going to get only this region. To get the entire region, we will multiply it by 2. Therefore, we have a is equal to 2. Both will have integral y dx. The first limit will be 0 to 2 and the second limit will be 2 to 3. So let us find the value of y from the parabola y square is equal to 2x. Now y square is equal to 2x, therefore the value of y will be under root 2 into under root x. In the second parabola we have minus 4x plus 12 or 12 minus 4x. So the value of y will be under root of 12 minus 4x. So let us substitute the values of y in both the integral. In the next step, we can take root 2 common outside. From here, 4 can be taken out as outside. From here, we can take 4 common outside. That will give you square root of 4, that is 2. Root x can be written as x raised to half. We have 2. Taking 4 common, we have 4 3s and 4 1s. This will give you 2 into root 2 as it is. Integration of x raised to half is x raised to 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2, whose reciprocal 2 by 3 will be multiplied within limit 0 to 2. Plus 2, again taking this 3 minus x raised to half, it will be 3 minus x raised to 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2, whose reciprocal 2 by 3 is directly multiplied. And since this is a composite function, the derivative of 3 minus x, that is minus 1, will be divided within limits 2 to 3. Now let us substitute the upper and the lower limits. This will give you root 2 into 2 as 2 root 2 upon 3. X raised to 3 by 2 within limit 0 to 2. Plus into minus will give you minus. Here we have 2 to the 4 upon 3. 3 minus x raised to 3 by 2 within limits 2 to 3. After substituting the upper and lower limits, we will get x as 2 raised to 3 by 2 minus, keeping x as 0, this will give you 0. Further, we have 3 minus 3, that will give you again 0, minus, the lower limit is 2. 3 minus 2 is 1 and 1 raised to 3 by 2 is 3 by 2 only. So we have 2 into 2 root 2 upon 3 into 2 raised to 3 by 2 minus 4 by 3 into minus 1 left. Writing root 2 as 2 raised to half and here minus into minus will give you plus 4 by 3. We have 2 into 2 raised to 1 into 2 raised to half into 2 raised to 3 by 2. So all these 3 powers will be added. So 1 plus half will give you 3 by 2 and 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2 will give you 6 by 2 and 6 by 2 is 3 only. 2 cube is 8. So 8 upon 3 plus 4 upon 3. That will give you 8 plus 4 as 12 upon 3. Here we have 3 1s, 3 4s. And 4 into 2 will give you 8 square units. This is our final answer. I hope friends you have understood this problem. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and subscribe to Ekeeda.